Hello everyone, I'm Jung Chul. Today's topic SE Linux. SE Linux means Security Enhanced Linux System. In this video, there are two parts. So part one, we focus on the SE Linux, the concept, and the part two, we'll focus on SE Linux, the configuration. Part 1 SE Linux concept. Access control. Before we study the SE Linux, we have to understand the concept of access control, including the Linux, all kinds of the operating system implement discretionary access control. Normally we say it's a DSC or DAC over resources. Here, resources means files or directories. It means users normally have the discretion to allow or deny access to resources that they have control. It means normally users can have all kinds of the right to allow or deny access for our resources such as files or directory. But if the process is compromised, it operates with the access control given to that process. And the higher level the security implements the access control in the system, normally we say MAC, mandatory access control. So this kind in the MAC, the access to resources managed by security policies, not users. This here users mean normally is a root. SE Linux is it mean the security enhanced Linux. So what is the SE Linux? SE Linux is the implementation of mandatory access control mechanism in Linux kernels. So if we use the Linux system, normally the Linux kernel does support these SE Linux features. And the SE Linux normally check for allowed operations after standard. This discretionary access control are checked. So even if we use SE Linux, normally our kernel, the Linux kernel, support DAC as well. So DAC first can be the check by the kernel, and after that we can use SE Linux like the mandatory access control like SE Linux. So though what is the goal of the SE Linux is to protect user space from system spaces. Normally user space has a lot of data and information, so we must protect our user space from the system spaces. So user data like a file or the directory, this one must be protected from the possibly vulnerable system the services. So here MAC and DAC, who can do what to which files? So MAC, mandatory access control like SE Linux. Normally this here under the control of the security administrator like using the security the policies. And the DAC, discretionary access control. So this one belong to like traditional Linux systems. Normally this kind of system can be controlled by the user, especially the root. SE Linux history, so mandatory access control is a MAC, so used in high security system, for example, like for the military organizations for years. And the NSA developed the SE Linux, so NSA began to work on embedding MAC into existing operating systems. So at first time, we could not use the SE Linux because Linux kernel doesn't support SE Linux, but in the middle of the Linux system history, NSA developed this SE Linux system, especially when the 1991, 1992 Mac OS, and 95 the distributed trusted OS, and 99 the Flux advanced security kernels. But now NSA changed the name is Azure Security Enhanced Linux after two in 2000 years. SE Linux architecture, we can say the Linux SE Linux is a Linux security model is built into the Linux kernel. So normally, as Linux working inside the Linux kernel, and as Linux is driven by loadable policy rules. So normally, as Linux can be implemented by policy rules. And when security relevant access is taking place, such as when, for example, like a process try to attempt to open a file. So here we can say process is a subject and file is an object. The operation is intercept in the kernel by SELinux. If SELinux policy rules allows the operation, it continues. Otherwise, the operation is blocked and process receive an error messages. Remember that even if we use the SC Linux as a Mac, but normally we also must use the DAC as well. So first, DAC can be used to deny access the first, and after that, SC Linux policy can be used using policy rules. As in its decision process. So here, first, subject, like a process or user action request, for example, like a read. And then SC Linux security server will receive this request from the subject. And after that, SC Linux the security server will try to apply this policy rules from database to this request. If SNS security server permitted this request, then the subject can access the object like a file or directory. But if this SNS security server did not permit this request, then this kind of the process will be saved here A, B, C, especially to denied messages. So the ABC mean access vector cache. Normally this one allowing or this line access can be the cache here. SC Linux mode, SC Linux has three kinds of mode. So if we want to change this mode, you have to configure this by etc sysconfig / SC Linux. So enforcing, it means SC Linux has already many kinds of the policy rules. So this kind of policy will be the enforced. So using or according to this, the SC Linux policy, the deny access based on SC Linux policy rules. Permissive, SC Linux policy is not enforced. SC Linux does not deny access, but deniers are low for actions. What kind of actions here? This kind of action would have been denied if running in enforcing mode. Even if we use the permissive mode, but some denier actions can be logged. And this kind of action come from where? Enforcing. Even if we don't deny this kind of access permit, but logged this kind of for this kind of actions. And disabled, as it needs to disable only, in this case, we can use only the DAC. If we want to change this kind of the SNS mode, also we can use the command as well, especially set enforce. Set enforce command to change between enforcing and permissive mode. So to change the enforcing mode here, we can use like, at first time we need to check our mode first as its status, and after that we can change like this, set enforce. Set enforce means the enforcing mode. To change the permissive mode, then we can use setEnforce 0 here, setEnforce 0. And after that, if we want to check our mode, we can use also this command getEnforce. SC Linux security context. Normally, if we use the SC Linux, normally the process and files are labeled with the SC Linux context. Normally, this kind of context contains the additional information about this kind of the file and directory. And in this kind of information has like a SC Linux user, role, type, and the label. So SC Linux context means is a kind of combination of user, role, type, and the label. So here Who is the user for these the resources, and what is their role, and what can they do like this? This is a kind of the example. If we want to see the security content as it is security content, then we have to use this kind of the option JIT. So here, unconfined U mean the user, object, role mean R mean role, user under home, T mean the type, S general mean is a rabbit. So here, user means, this one, user's type means who are logging in the system currently, for example, like a normal user root like this. And each Linux user etc in the etc password is mapped to SNS user beyond SNS policy. So if we want to see this kind of mapping information, we have to use this in the command manage login hyphen r. And the root under by u user under by UR system. This is a kind of example of the user. Type B. Type normally is to define the domain for process and type for files. So for the process and files. So if we use the process, this one can be the domain. But if we use file, this one is a type. As in Linux policy rules to define the how the types can access each other, whether it be the domain accessing type or domain accessing another domain like this. So this kind of type we can find the system admin, user type, or name type like this. Role, this one, is to define what domain a user is allowed to access. For example, user role or step role like this. Rebel is two kinds, multi-level security and multi-category security. Normally we say this one MLS, this one we say MCS. And using Rebel, we can allow the identification of multiple levels of security. So for example, like S0 is a kind of, it's the default Rebel. And allow also the users use of the multiple categories. So if we want to check or if we want to see the this kind of category, then we need to check this file. It is CS, it needs to target and set trans.conf. So here we can find this kind of the labels. And this kind of label is designed to secure information in labels. It means the raw reader will write down. So here, for this kind of the policy, this one we can say the Bell-LaPadula security models. And the SNS access control, there are three kinds of SNS access control. First one, the TE, this one, type enforcement. So type enforcement normally confine the limit, the process. It's a, normally you can say it's a subject process to each the domain by using security context. So some the process can be used only for some domains by TE. This one is a primary mechanism to access control used in target policy. In the second file, I will explain the target policy. Be it the role-based access control is the RBAC. So this one recognizes that you just often need to move from one domain to another domain. So RBAC rules is precisely allow the roles to move from one domain to another domain. So based around the CNS users, this one not used in the default target first. The primary mechanism TE is a primary mechanism in the target policy, but this one I use for the default. And the multi-level securities mean the MLS. So this one is enforced the Bell-LaPadula security models. So it means users allowed to read at own level cannot read a higher level. Also, users allowed to write at one level are not allowed to write at low level. So this kind of policy we can say is a Bell-LaPadula security models. So this one ensures that the secure information does not propagate to lower levels. Okay, thank you for watching the SELENCE part 1, and the next video I will explain the part 2 about the SELENCE configuration. Thanks for watching and see you next video.